Name?
Jim.
Occupation?
James Douglas Morrison was born on December 3, 1943 in Florida. He was an American singer, poet, and songwriter, who was also the lead vocalist for rock band The Doors. He was an eccentric since his early years. Early in Morrison's childhood, the boy would have a life-changing experience. While riding through the New Mexico desert at around age 5, he saw the aftermath of a car accident and would later describe seeing the dead bodies of Native Americans on the side of the road. While his family members have said that the accident was exaggerated by Morris, the event had an alarming effect on him. Morrison would later say of the incident that it was the first time he tasted fear. Morrison was also into history. He had his hair cut to emulate the looks of Alexander the Great. In 1967, Morrison enrolled in UCLA to study film. He and his UCLA classmate Ray Manzarek formed The Doors in the summer of 1965. Soon after, Robbie Krieger and John Densmore joined the band, which jump-started their career and Morrison's public presence. Jim was infamous for his scandalous and outright weird performances, his provocative lyrics, disturbing imagery, and his leather pants. He was known as the Lizard King due to his obsession with lizards. After years of drinking a heavy drug used, he had developed the belief that he was able to control lizards with power of his mind. And as it often is with artists, he was heavily into opiates. LSD, marijuana, and alcohol were his saving graces.
Since many people thought that Jim and Janis Joplin could have been a match made in heaven, producer Rothschild thought it would be a good idea to invite the musicians to a party. But Morrison's unpleasant drunk behavior pretty much ruined the whole night. Morrison grabbed Janis Joplin by her hair while she was leaving, and Joplin quickly grabbed a bottle and hit Morrison's head. In 1967, at a concert in New Haven, Jim was arrested on stage because he was inciting a riot, which only added to his mysterious and enigmatic image. Jim Morrison was rock and roll's first self-declared poet. The words he wrote, whether you love them or hate them, have forgotten them or live by them, would go on to rewrite pop music history forever.
I have a vision of America, seen from the air, 28,000 feet and going fast. A one-armed man in a Fresno parking labyrinth. A giant primeval bird, a burnt tree in an empty lot in Modesto. And miles of hotel corridors. And elevators filled with citizens. One night in Boston, I was attacked from behind by an anxious citizen.
Morrison's most indulgent relationship was with Pamela Corson. They were both hippies, free spirits, and often on breaks. During their breaks, Jim often had relationships with other women, including a witch named Patricia Kennelly, with whom he had a weekend wedding. Soon after, they found out she was pregnant, and the two of them decided to terminate. Jim promised that he would be there to hold her hand, but he never came. Jim Morrison left America in 1971 and moved to Paris with Pamela. He was somewhat happy in Paris. He wrote a lot and recorded his last album, An American Prayer, but there was something odd in the air. He often talked about death and that he will soon die, which was odd since he was only 27.
Rock musician was disclosed today. Jim Morrison, 27 years old, lead singer of The Doors. His manager said Morrison died 6 days ago in Paris, either of a heart attack or pneumonia. But the death was kept secret to avoid a sensation. He was buried in Paris in the same cemetery where Balzac and other French immortals lie.